Up until now, we've been working with blank workbooks. But in this lesson, we'll open an existing workbook. In order to open a workbook, you'll first need to download the sample files from the ExcelCentral.com website. Now, you're probably already in the ExcelCentral.com website watching this video, but I'll have to open a browser. So I'll click Internet Explorer, and in the bar at the top of the screen, type www.excelcentral.com. And I'm taken to the Excel Central website. In the menu bar at the top of the screen, you can see that there's a Sample Files option. I'll click Sample Files now. And because this is the Excel 2013 Essential Skills course, I'll click the orange button above Excel 2013 Essential Skills. You can now see that there are two options to download your files. I strongly recommend that you use the recommended option, because this will automatically extract the files into the correct place on your hard drive. So, why do I also offer a zip file option? Well, that's because some companies and a few antivirus products may block the download of executable files. But there's a downside to downloading a zip file. If you do, you'll have to click the Enable Editing button every time you open a sample file. So I'll choose the recommended option. Because I'm using Internet Explorer, a bar pops up now asking if I want to run or save the file. If you're using a different browser, you might see a slightly different dialogue. I'll click the Run option, and I now see a dialogue enabling me to extract the files to my hard drive. If you look at the Unzip to Folder box, you'll see that by default this will go in the C, Practice, Excel 2013 Essential Skills folder. And unless you've got a good reason for not storing the sample files there, that's the best place to put them. So I'll now click the Unzip button, and all of the files are installed on my computer. I'll click OK and close this dialog. And now I'll close the web browser as well. I'm now ready to use my sample files. So let's open one of the sample files. I'll click the Start button, as I'm using Windows 8, and the Excel 2013 tile. And instead of using the blank workbook template, I'm going to click the Open Other Workbooks link on the left-hand bar. These files have been installed onto the hard drive on my computer, so I'll click Computer on the left-hand bar. I now need to look for the files, so I'll click the Browse button. And you'll remember that I installed these files on my C drive, so in the left-hand part of File Explorer, I'll click the C drive. You may also remember that they were stored in the Practice folder, so I'll double-click the Practice folder in the right-hand pane. If you've got other Smart Method courses, you may see the sample file sets for those as well. But the one we're interested in is Excel 2013 Essential Skills. And because this course has 8 sessions, you'll see 8 folders. The session we're working in now is Session 1. So I'll double-click Session 1, and you can see that Session 1 has just 2 sample files. The sample file we're going to open is the Wealth of Nations. You can either click once on the file and then click the Open button, or you'll find it quicker to double-click on the file to open it in Excel. Now that you've opened a sample file, let's talk about the names of some of the things that you're seeing on the Excel screen. First of all, notice that one of the cells has a green line around it. That's the cell with Luxembourg written within it. This is called the active cell. Now look at the name box at the top left of the screen. You'll notice this has B3 written in it. This is called a cell address, and it's the cell address of the active cell. Let me explain how cell addresses work. Excel uses the letter of the column and the number of the row to identify cells. In the above example, the cell address of the active cell is B3. In Excel 2013, there are a little over a million rows and a little over 16,000 columns. You might wonder how it's possible to name all of these columns with only 26 letters in the alphabet. When Excel runs out of letters, it starts using two, X, Y, Z, and then AA, AB, AC. But even two letters is not enough. When Excel reaches column ZZ, it starts using three letters, ZX, ZY, ZZ, and then AAA, AAB, and AAC. Now let's use the name box to move to a specific cell. I'm going to click inside the name box and type ZZ3. And when I press the Enter key, you'll see that I'm teleported to cell ZZ3. Let's now move back to cell A1. Now you could do this by typing A1 in the name box and pressing the Enter key, but I'll show you a quicker way to do it. Hold down the Control key on your keyboard and press the Home key on your keyboard, and this takes you straight back to cell A1. You can also move to the last cell in the worksheet using this technique, and you can do this by holding down the Control key and then pressing the End key on your keyboard. And you can see that the last row in this worksheet is row 230. Now let's look at a different way of moving around the worksheet using the scroll bars. There's two scroll bars in the Excel window. The vertical scroll bar runs from top to bottom of the window on the right-hand side, and it allows you to quickly move up and down the worksheet. The horizontal scroll bar is at the bottom right-hand side of the window and allows you to move to the left and the right in wide worksheets. Let's look at how the scroll bars work. I'm going to click on the button in the middle of the vertical scroll bar, and if I click and drag, you can see that I can move up and down the worksheet. If I want to move one row at a time, it's a little difficult to do with the button, because things move a little too quickly. So I can use the arrow keys at the top and at the bottom of the scroll bar to move up one row at a time, or to move down one row at a time. Often you'll want to read every piece of information in a worksheet, and to do that we can read information one page at a time. You can see that the page currently displays rows 91 to rows 111. And if I've read this entire page and want to start reading at row 112, I can click in the grey area below the button. And when I click once, there's row 112. And down another page to row 133. I can also move up a page at a time using the same technique. Let me now show you a very advanced technique that very few Excel users know. That is how to scroll very quickly through a worksheet. Remember, a worksheet can have over a million rows, and it would take you a long time if you're trying to get to the bottom of such a worksheet by clicking the down arrow. In fact, it could take you several hours. But if you hold down the Shift key and then drag the button in the scroll bar to the bottom, you'll see that you move really rapidly down the worksheet. We're already at row 1,048,576, the last row that a worksheet can contain data within. And let's move back to cell A1 using the same technique. I'll hold down Shift, drag the button all the way to the top, and we're back again in row 1. Before we finish this lesson, let's talk about one more item on screen, and that's the formula bar. If I click in cell B3 to make it the active cell, you can see that the word Luxembourg has appeared in the formula bar. The formula bar always displays the contents of the active cell, and we'll be using the formula bar a lot more later in the course. You've now completed lesson 1.5. Download the sample files and open and navigate a workbook.